इच्छन्ति देवाः सुन्वन्तं नास्वप्नाय स्मृहयन्ति. शङ्खं चक्रं जलौकां च दधतमृतं घटं चारुदोर्भिश्चतुर्भिः सूक्ष्मानि रुढ्या सुखपरिविलसं मौलिमं भोजनेत्रं कालाम्भोदोज्वराङ्गं कटितटविलसश्चारुपीताम्बराढ्यं वन्दे धन्वन्तरिं तं निखिलगदवनं प्रौढदावाग्निनीलम् प्रौढदावाग्निनीलम्.
I would like to thank Infinity Foundation, Dr. Sunit ji, Anand Paranspe ji, Mukul ji Kanitkar for giving me an opportunity to revise my understanding of Ayurveda in front of great scholars. The topic on which I am going to speak is Ayurveda and psychology. The subject very, very close to my heart, we will have a bird's eye view of ancient Indian knowledge and the basic concepts of Ayurveda that are so closely related to the psychology. Ayurveda, the ancient indigenous health science, is prominent among many branches of science that were developed by ancient Indian seers. It deals with the laws of life, health, and disease with an emphasis on a lifestyle which is so conducive to one's own health. The accuracy with which Ayurveda strikes a harmony between individuals and society is astounding. The term Ayurveda is self-defined. Ayu means life, Veda is knowledge. Interesting to know that Ved also knows as attainment. So Ayurveda, the powerful applied science, equip us to live a healthy and full life, to go through a journey of 100 years of growth, and not growing old, but growth. We can thereby achieve all the four pursuits of the life: dharma, artha, kaam, and moksha. That is the purpose of life. Most of us spend a lifetime attaining only two pursuits, that is artha and kama. But then there's a big flaw in that approach. The basic foundations remain neglected, that is dharma. Ayurveda is defined as hita hitam sukham dukham ayuhu tasya hita hitam mananca tachayo yatroktam ayurvedah sa uchyate. Ayurveda is science where beneficial and harmful, as well as pleasant and unpleasant states of life, along with what is good and bad for life, its measurement and life itself is described. It encompasses the total sweep of life sciences and perceives the quest of understanding life in all its ramifications. The very objective of Ayurveda is swasthasya swasthya rakshanam aturasya vyadhi parimokshaha. Ayurveda is science which thinks of an individual as a whole, not only about his diseases or disorders, but how to maintain his health and how to achieve ease from disease. While defining a healthy person, Ayurveda says samadosha sama agni samadhatu malakriya prasanna atma indriya manaha swastha iti abhidhiyate. While defining healthy person, it has taken into consideration bio, psycho, socio and spiritual aspect. It talks about balance in body constituents of dosha, dhatu, agni and mala. I am not going into the depth details of this, but just I am going to introduce you to certain concepts. Tridosh, on which the basic constituent of body or sharir prakruti constituents. Vata, it is combination of akash and vayu tattva. Pitta, combination of agni and jala tattva. And kapha, combination of jala and prithvi tattva. Vata is a biological air humor which governs the movement. It is responsible for the discharge of impulses, both voluntary and involuntary. Vata rules the basic sensitivity and mobility. Fear and anxiety are its disturbances. Pitta, the second constituent, biological fire humor, it's called as pitta, it governs a transformation in the body and mind as digestion and assimilation on all levels, from food to ideas. Brajak pitta is for brain. Anger is its main emotional disturbance. Kapha, the biological water humor is called kapha. It gives weight, stability, but it can prevent growth and expansion. Desire and attachment are its two disturbances. Ayurveda believes in God and reincarnation. Mind, a very profound concept, very well defined, elaborated in very scientific way, with which the philosophical assumptions of Sankhya and Atharvaveda are taken into consideration. Mind is a storehouse of vasanas, innate tendencies acquired during many past lives. Mind is also called as an antakarana. Karana is tool, anta is internal. There are four tools in antakarana: mana, buddhi, chitta, and ahankara. The first tool is mind, antakarana. Further are more subtler than the mind. Ayurveda talks about manovaha srotasa. In Ayurveda, mind is taught as a system, like they are taught of digestive system, respiratory system. So mind is taught as a system with its location, constitution, and function. Mind comprises of three gunas: sattva, raja, and tama. Sattva denoted by white color, raja by red, and tamas by black color. Sattva resembles knowledge. It imparts balance. Few features are excellence of intellect, gentleness, forgiveness, truthfulness, endurance. There are seven variants, that is personality types, with sattva dominance. Then comes rajas, energy which causes imbalance. Rajas is characterized by egoistic, being distressed, lustful, joyous, passionate, angry. Six variants with rajas dominance are seen. Then come tamas. Black color denoted inertia, ignorance are its main characteristics. Inactivity, apathy, ignorance. They always look dejected. Excessive sleep is one of the characteristics. There are three variants with tama dominance. Functions of mind: chintam vicharyam uhyam cha dheyam sankalpameva cha yat kinchit manuso dnyayam tat sarvam arthasaudhnyakam. Functions of mind: chintyam is cerebration, vicharyam, that is consideration, uhyam, that is speculation, dheyam, that is contemplation, and sankalpa, that is conviction. These are the five functions of mind, along with yat kinchit. Yat kinchit means miscellaneous, other subtleties that can be perceived by mind without any aid of sense faculties are also considered functions of mind. The three pillars for ideal health considered by Ayurveda are ahar, nidra, and brahmacharya. Ahar is food, nidra is proper sleep, and brahmacharya. Brahmacharya is self-control. Brahmacharya is popularly misunderstood to mean abstinence from sexual life. Brahmacharya means living in self-control with respect to all our sense enjoyments and does not mean their total denial. Mental state examination. Ayurveda considers mental state examination manobuddhi saujnanyanam smruti bhakti shila cheshta achara vibhrakam nighat. There are 8 folds on which mental state examination has to be taken. Mana is emotional level, buddhi, his decision-making power, saujnanyan, his orientation of time, place, person, smruti, his memory, bhakti, his desires, shil, his habits, cheshta, his psychomotor functioning, and achar, conduct and behavior. These are the 8-fold way of mental state examination given in Ayurveda. Now let us understand the reason for pathology or psychopathology or disease. Ayurveda speaks of 3 basic factors on which any pathology occurs. Asatma Indriyartha Sanyog, Prajnaparad and Parinam. Asatma Indriyartha Sanyog is unwholesome or incompatible contact. When there is an absence of right contact with an object, it is called Asatma Indriya Artha Sanyog. Artha is object, Asatma is incompatible. 3 types of incompatible contacts which are being spoken of are Ati Yoga, Ayoga and Mithya Yoga. These are the 3 reasons for pathology. Ati Yoga is excessive use, Ayoga is deficient use and Mithya Yoga is erroneous use or wrong use. Like hearing of high intensity of sound for longer duration can be termed as Ati Yoga. Not hearing at all can be termed as Ayoga. And hearing something frightening or terrifying sounds can be called as Mithya Yoga. Children's listening to Shinchan cartoon probably is one of the Mithya Yoga. Establishing right contact is an art, and our scriptures guide us saying Om Bhadram Karne Bishrunyam Devaha Bhadram Pashyemaksha Bhirya Jatraha Sthirai Anges Tushtvas Astunubihi Vyashevam Devam Hitam Yadayuhu. Our scripture has always guided us what to do. They know the psychology. Because if we say not to do, we always end up doing same. And so it has been advised, listen auspicious, read auspicious. That is what Bhadram Karanibhi says. Now, to second part, Prajna Paradaha. The discriminative and judgment ability of human beings are the concern of wisdom, intelligence, or understanding that is known as Prajna. The defective application of Prajna is called as Prajna Paradha or volitional transgression. Charaka has stated the misuse of karma and buddhi as synonyms. And therefore, prajnaparadha, or related to karma, we perform 3 types of karma, kayik, vachik and manasik. And so on all 3 levels, there can be a prajnaparadha. Bhukshadya vishama vidnyanam vishamam cha pravartanam prajnaparadham cha janiyat manaso gocharam hitat. Intellectual pseudo-conception and resultant improper conduct represents intellectual blasphemy or volitional transgression. Pseudo-conception is Vishama Vidnyanam and resultant improper conduct is Vishama Pravartan. Also, Prajnaparadha is wonderfully defined as Dhi Dhruti Smriti Vibhrashtaha Karmayet Kurute Ashubham Prajnaparadham Cha Tam Vidyat Sarva Dosha Prakopanam. For all pathologies, disequilibrium, Prajnaparadha is supposed to be one of the major constituent. So, impairment of intellect, that is something which is useful, viewed as harmful and vice versa. Impairment of patience, that is the dhruti. Impairment of patience is dhruti. Impairment of intellect is the. So, patience restrains mind from getting attracted and attached to harmful objects. But if patience is impaired, the mind indulges in worldly enjoyments. And impairment of memories, that is disorder in process of recollection or reproduction of the memories. Parinama, time factor. Definite sequence of accumulation, aggravation and pacification of doshas are considered. There are certain time where the doshas of body are aggravated or pacified. So there are saushaman kal, prakopa kal, various kals are there of these doshas, and that has to be taken consideration. If they are not followed, then there are chances of pathology. Seasonal variations, where Ayurveda speaks of rutucharya, in various rutus, how our behavior or how we should behave whole day, that has been prescribed, that is called as rutucharya. So there are these three factors causes pathology: asatma indriya artha sanyog, prajna prada, and time factor. And then how to deal with this, how to overcome this? For that, Ayurveda has prescribed remedy, and that is daiva vipashray chikitsa, yukti vipashray chikitsa, and sattva vajay. Daiva vipashray chikitsa is of which considers of magico religious practices. Yukti vipashray is rational therapy, and satvajay is psychotherapy. Magico religious practices. There are various magico religious practices that are prescribed in Ayurveda. Some of them are mantra, that is incarnations of mantras, speaking mantra, chanting mantras, home, aushadam, upahara, upavasa, gamanam, that is pilgrimage, prayashchittam, that is penitence, satsanga, many more, but I have only enlisted few just to make you aware of. This is also one part of chikitsa, where a person can come out of a thought fixation stage. Then it speaks of rational therapy. Rational therapy or saṁśodhana, it is popularly known as panchakarma. Panchakarma, most of people are aware, which talks of vamana, virechana, basti, nasya, and raktamokshana. This panchakarma therapy is boon to mankind, which helps in detoxification of body. Samartha Ramdas Swami says, Sharira Sarikhe Anika Yantra Nahi. There is one of the best instruments that has been prepared is human body. And we all possess instruments, and we go for servicing of that instruments. Like we have vehicles, we go for regular servicing of that vehicles. It is just to remove the impurities or detoxification. Rational palliative therapy, that is internal medication, which I am not going to speak of because it is a youth subject. And then diet, activities, and deeds. These are the regimes that has been advised in rational therapy. Now, diet is considered as one of the best medicine. Annamaya hi saumya manaha. What we eat gets converted into mind. So, when we are dealing with normal persons or abnormal person, we should take into consideration his diet regime. Because most of the disorders are caused because of alpasattvata or heenasattvata. Less quantity of sattvagun or inferior quantity of sattvagun. And so Ayurveda prescribes growing of sattvagun, which will take care of reducing of raja and tama. Diet is to be considered on physical level as well as mental level also. The thoughts, sattvic vichar, rajasic vichar, and tamasic vichar also has to be taken into consideration here. Sattva vajay. Now this is related to psychology of Ayurveda, psychotherapy of Ayurveda. Six regimes under sattvajaya, which Ayurveda has prescribed, is manonigraha, ashvasanadyaha, pratidvandvi bhava, manakshobhanam, sadvrittam, and samachittatvam. These are the six methods to overcome the pathology. Mind control methods, reconciliatory methods, replacement of emotions, psychophysical shock, moral behavior code, and mental equanimity. Manonigraha. Functions of mind, we have seen chintam vicharyam uyam cha deyam sankalpa. Now for manonigraha, we have to go again through this all five steps. Regulation of thought process, chintyam, the thought which comes in, then vicharyam, whether the thought which has come in is worth considering, then speculation, tarka adharit uya, tarka is inference, contemplation on that inferred thought, and then conviction of the notion conceived, that is where the mind job ends, and then that convicted notion has been to address to its superior, that is Buddhi, and Buddhi takes the nirane. Next. Ashvasanadhyaya, in this there are four things that we can do as psychotherapy. It is consolation, ashvasanam, it is consolation or encouragement. Santvanam, that is consolation or pacification. Danam, that is substitution. And prasadanam, that is purification. Now here again, purification, it relates with panchakarma, detoxification. One of the very original thought of charaka, pratidvandvi bhava. Pratidvandvi is replacement of emotions. What we popularly call it as principle of second line. When we draw one line and we have to prove that that line is shorter, we just draw a bigger line next to that. We don't deal with that smaller line to make it short. So replacement of emotions is one of the best therapy to overcome that. Kama shoka bhaya krodha harsha irsha lobha sambhavan paraspara pratidvandvi abhi evam shamamam nayet. That is how charaka has given us. These are various emotions and how to counter, which emotion to counter has been given in this chart, which I will not go, just to say, for fear we have to work on valor and not reducing the fear. Manakshobhanam, psychophysical shock. It is also called as fear therapy. Induction of fear as well as psychological methods with fear of life, person changes his entire approach and attitudes. A person after heart attack and before heart attack, you can see the various difference in his behavior, in his approach. So once fear of life is given, he can change his attitude and approach. So this is one of the therapy. Sadvruttam, moral behavior code, ethical practices. Proper code, dinacharya, rutucharya has been given under this. It serves two main purposes. Control over oneself through control over mind and sensory organs, and social obligation through right and proper behavior. One of the best thing that Ayurveda speaks of is dharaniya veg and adharaniya veg. Dharaniya are suppressible and adharaniya are non-suppressible. That is, on mental level, grief, fear, anger, vanity, jealousy, that has to be suppressed. Physical level, violence, adultery, theft, suppressed. Harsh words, backbiting, untimely words, suppress. Ayurveda speaks of suppression, which will not relate to any pathology. But if suppressed under proper understanding, it doesn't create pathology. Individual lives on four levels: physical level, emotional level, intellectual level, and spiritual level. The aim is one should grow from one level to another level where he can overcome his problems. Samachittatvam, mental equanimity. Here there are again various steps. So dhairyam, fortitude, prudence, patience, remembrance, cognizance, true knowledge, and absolute tranquility. These are the various steps or methods considered in Ayurveda. As far as what we probably deal with as psychology, as far as Ayurveda is concerned. But like yesterday, Sunday, one of the speaker, he told that there is nothing called as psychology in Ayurveda, but what there is Ayurvedic psychiatry. I am with him, because the psychology is basically knowledge of Atman. Finished. 1 minute. Knowledge of Atman, and we have to work on that science where knowledge of Atman is given, then we can call it as psychology. Right now, what we are dealing with is just behavioral science, observation of behavior patterns. So every individual is manufactured with three manufacturing defects. One is impurities of mind, second is agitation, and third one is ignorance. And that should be the path for overall individuals to grow. Lastly, I would like to sum up my session. The world is going through sad paradox. Even if he is sitting on the mountain top of wealth and prosperity, man lives a life of sadness, worry, anxiety, and dissatisfaction. To overcome this sad paradox, Indian psychology and Ayurveda and applied science will stand like a lighthouse and guide humanity with its strong philosophical principles for now and forever. Sarvesham swastir bhavatu, sarvesham shantir bhavatu, sarvesham purnam bhavatu, sarvesham mangalam bhavatu, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukha bhag bhavet. Thank you so much.